AEW tried to poach a WWE Hall of Famer. We've got an update on Mickie James in this year's Royal Rumble, and two Royal Rumble entrants have been leaked. Find out who in a bit. So we're kicking things off talking about somebody who is very, very much fresh on the mind, but also somebody that AEW tried to poach, it turned out. She's going to be in this year's Royal Rumble. She was on SmackDown last night. We'll talk about that in a little bit.
Ooh.
Lita wanted, AEW wanted her for a top program last year. This is via Fightful Select. Very interesting stuff indeed, because she's practically a WWE lifer. I know she was like, she did ECW for a bit, right?
Yeah, she came in through ECW, I believe, to WWE, following her stint there.
She's WWE through and through.
When you think of Lita, you think of, you know, Team Extreme, right? That's the first thing your mind goes to.
Somebody who is who's been inducted into the Hall of Fame in, I believe, 2014. Fightful dropping a very interesting bit here. The program would have positioned Lita in a top feud with the women's champion, Britt Baker. And this would have been like a short-term thing. She wasn't going to be signed to a long-term deal or anything, but a feud working up to All Out 2021, where instead Britt successfully defended a title against Chris Statlander instead.
Yeah.
But the great thing about this, and I think it would have been brilliant because I'm a big Lita fan anyway, the talks ended positively and it didn't work out, but they're on good terms and business may still yet happen somewhere down the line.
I'd like to see that. I think, you know, when Lita returned for the Rumble, the first sort of Rumble they did, and, you know, Lita came down with all the names written all over her and everything. Just the excitement of having Lita back, everybody popped real hard for it. Everybody was super excited to see her again. She feels like somebody who will just always be welcome in wrestling. Yeah. Like, everybody will always be happy to see her. So it's a no-brainer if AEW were able to get her. But, yeah, we'll talk more about her a bit more on SmackDown, because she said some interesting things there as well.
Oh, absolutely. Lita returning to SmackDown for the first time in almost 20 years.
Yeah, she hasn't been on the blue brand in almost 20 years. So she came back.
Jesus Christ. That makes me feel very old.
I did that 2002 in review, and I think there's one point in the script, and it's like, so 20 years ago, and I'm like, oh, that hurt my insides.
Right, okay. But yeah, what did she say?
She was announced, obviously, for the Rumble last week, but she came back. She said that now that, you know, the women have their own Rumble match, she feels like she's got one last little run left in her, and that was the interesting thing. And then she's going off, she's talking, and then she of course gets interrupted by Charlotte Flair. The two traded kind of awkward verbal blows, but Lita got a giant head chant going about Charlotte. Charlotte then promised to throw Lita out. She ran down Trish and said, you know, I forced Trish Stratus to retire, and, you know, Lita's not going to take that about her best mate. And then she threatened to do the same to Lita. She's going to throw her out, she's going to win, she's going to pick her own WrestleMania main event opponent. Lita then just slapped her and hit her with a twist of fate, and the crowd got excited for it. So there's
Lita's next program, right?
Yeah,
Charlotte is going to throw her out. She's going to prove what she said she's going to do, and then we're going to get Lita versus Charlotte at Mania, which is great.
Yeah, it's.
I'm up for
fingers
that.
Crossed. It'll be a great match, and, you know, if Lita is saying that she is ready to have, you know, one last little run, then I think this would be quite a nice one to do. And you've got the Trish thread running through it as well. So,
yeah, for sure, a nice little 3-month program to say goodbye to Lita good and proper until she turns up at the next Rumble. Obviously,
they're short names,
like they are every year. I think that's really cool. Sure, it's a bit of a predictable feud as far as the Charlotte winning and everything goes, but that's a bit of fun. Do you reckon it'll be for a title? Do you reckon Charlotte will?
I'd like to see it for the title. I'd like to see them make it feel a bit more than just, hey, it's a legend, everybody. You know how it's going to go. Like, if they were to surprise us and bust something out, I'd be keen to see.
Have her win it. She still looks about 22.
It'd be
mental. She can go for another 20 years.
It'd hit headlines because it's an easy one, isn't it? Everybody remember Lita. Like, and everybody who's fell off wrestling will be like, yeah, as it's trending worldwide. So, makes sense.
Sticking with the Women's Royal Rumble now, we got an update on Mickie James after she was announced for this year's Rumble. She is, of course, with Impact at the moment. But from the Wrestling Observer newsletter, a couple of interesting notes here. James believed to not be under contract with Impact. She's working on a per-show deal. However, Impact's Scott D'Amore did actually work with WWE. It's something that he's talked about a fair bit over the last week or so, about how they came to terms on the deal. So it appears that she might have been free to do that anyway. I don't know the specifics of of her deal with Impact, but it's cool to hear that Impact were working with WWE. And as the gap closes with AEW, it's believed that WWE will become friendlier to the people that they weren't in the past, exactly as it happened in the late 90s.
Who could have predicted that happening, eh?
Right. But I guess maybe WWE's strategy here is actually to sort of wrestle away, sorry, sports entertainment.
Yeah, sports entertainment away.
Sports entertainment away. The Forbidden Door partners of AEW, do you think that makes sense? Is it like they might start working with these promotions so that they end up not working with AEW because WWE is still the bigger promotion?
So in a sense, trying to kind of choke out AEW of their friends. So,
yeah,
you know,
maybe.
You're not his best friend. I'm Impact's best friend. Come here. And then just pulling Impact away from Tony Khan. I could see that. You know, every single move WWE tends to make always feels sinister. It always feels a bit like the Empire and Star Wars. You know, there's somebody sat up top just kind of waiting patiently for their plan to take hold. But it wouldn't surprise me. But at the same time, I would like to think that maybe, you know, looking at how they've treated the wrestlers over the last 2 years or so, I don't think so. But maybe it'd be nice if they were just, you know, open and going, hey, it's Impact Wrestling. Hey, we're working with this company. Hey, we're doing this. But there's always that sense that there's an ulterior motive, isn't there?
Yeah, there is. Your mind often does jump to Fed Bad. Put that on SC Jerk. Will she be wearing her Impact Knockouts title, Sam?
So she was speaking with Ariel Helwani, and this was actually brought up in the conversation. She said, I hope so. I intend on it. It kind of goes with me everywhere. It's my identity right now. It's important because I stepped away from WWE and I've gone back to this hardcore country character. And it's something who I was never able to do for whatever reason. I think she might mean in WWE. She says, I think she had moments in there, but it was never hardcore country Mickey James in that sense. It's cool to bring that to WWE. It's who I am. And I am the champ. And I think at this point, if she isn't to come out with the belt, then that would really, it would affect people's opinion of WWE at this point, because they've gone, you know, they've done the thing they never do when they went, you know, Impact Wrestling Champion, and they acknowledged Impact. Surely, because they've said that, she's going to come out with her title. And I think that would actually be quite a nice moment for the audience, yeah. Because it would feel like finally WWE is starting to bring that wall down a little bit and go, hey, look, there are other promotions. We're working with them. And they've done it before, so, you know, we've had the NWA title on WWE TV before, so.
Yeah. A fair while ago.
Just a little bit.
That was Lita on SmackDown, right?
Yeah, definitely.
And one more note for the Women's Royal Rumble match before we move on. PW Insider leaking two names who are being scheduled for the show. We're not going to talk about these for too long. So skip forward, 40 seconds if you don't want to know these two names, if you want the surprise, but they're not huge. No disrespect. People that we've seen before. Melina, first of all, the bigger name. Melina's awesome. She can still go. We know that. I really like Melina. Mm. Jack really likes Melina. And and finally, Cameron as well, who is
I think the you know, it's sort of a safe thing because WWE, it feels like WWE's women's roster is getting particularly decimated as you know, the releases mount and mount and mount. And they've never really kind of, they've fallen off the wagon when, you know, they were really starting to champion women's wrestling. And so there's been a lot of back chat about this, hasn't there? Where it's like, oh, they're bringing back legends because they can't fill the, you know, the roster with the match with people from the roster and everything. But at the same time, I think, you know, Royal Rumble is the time to have people return. It is a big, exciting moment. It always is. And people will be excited to see Melina and they'll be excited to see Cameron, you know, like just for the sake of seeing them back, I think, like just for the kind of nostalgia.
Yeah,
you know?
Cameron's awesome. Yeah. I think I'm in the camp that, yeah, WWE can't be doing this every year. They can't have these same bloody 15 or so names.
They need to do it.
Four or five viable winners. They do need to sort that out because they can't do this forever.
That's it.
Not to say that I'm not excited about Cameron. That's awesome. That's great.
The more you see these people come in as the big surprises, it's you know it's a big surprise 1 year, but if it
diminishing
keeps
returns,
going,
right?
Yeah, diminishing returns. So
Heading over to the men's Royal Rumble match. As we finish this video, our four new competitors have been added to that match. Some big names here: Sami Zayn, Kofi Kingston, Happy Corbin, and the biggest name of all, Madcap Moss, all been added to the 2022 men's Royal Rumble match. Zayn, of course, is out gunning for Johnny Knoxville. Their interactions were everything that Sami has done.
Yeah.
Basically, since this heel turn, but especially the conspiracy stuff, has been so entertaining.
He's in such a renaissance right now. Yeah, he's like one of my favorite people in the entire company.
He's such a performer.
We've spoke about it before on the news, haven't we? Where it was like they're turning him heel, and it was like, and he's just taking it and ran with it. And this, especially when he announced it, it wasn't quite the announcement, but he was out there with a shopping cart on SmackDown last night, and he kept chickening out. And it was, it's just great. It's what you want to see from him.
It's really fun TV. And on a brand which is largely just really, really entertaining to watch anyway, the fact that Sami Zayn is standing out is just excellent to see.
It's sad, isn't it?
Sami Zayn appreciation tweet or something.
That we forget that wrestling can be fun.
No, wrestling's always fun. What are you talking about? Cameron's coming back. Right, that's it from us. We will see you very shortly with another video. Some big news coming. Stay tuned.